In the next few minutes, you're gonna learn about my coronavirus, my COVID-19 portfolio. That's right, I bought everything at the lowest of the lows, the bottom of the bottoms so far. Will there be another bottom? I don't know, but did I get it at the current bottom? Yes, I did. And I got it all in my Charles Schwab portfolio. I will break it down stock by stock. Comment, like, and subscribe. I know there's nothing to comment yet. The video just started, but, you know, trigger the algorithm. I'm excited. Hey guys, you might notice the tone in this video is very different from my usual spunky self. I know the intro was my usual spunky self. Corona is a very serious thing. I know not a lot of people that we know personally are gonna be dying because of it. We are all gonna be affected, so I'm not gonna add little memes. Every time I say coronavirus, I was gonna add Cardi B. You know the thing that she does. But I decided not to because, you know, it's a tough time. I had a friend pass away, and I still wanted to release this video because I definitely wanted to share this portfolio before things changed even more. Now, a lot of like hardcore like value investors are going to be really mad at some of the philosophies in this video because I did not look at any data picking these stocks. It's another philosophy. It's not that popular right now, but the investing world is changing. You got companies like Tesla, top three competitors combined, overvalued by like immense proportions, and they're still going up and up and up. Sometimes you need a fresh approach, and remember, I'm not a financial advisor or anything like that. I'm just a guy on the internet, and I really love this, and I'm passionate about it, and hopefully bringing a new perspective. You definitely should not copy anything that I do because, you know, it could all go to zero. Who knows? I'm just sharing what I think and how I do it, and this is how I spent my stimulus check. Let's get into this. Let's break it down. But first, here's what I want to say. Before we look into the Charles Schwab portfolio, where I'll show you how I invested during the crash, I want to talk about investing for the future and investing during crashes in general. Now, when we do have a major crash of 20% or more, you know, that's how we technically define a crash. A correction is about 10% and a dip is about 3-5%. A lot of times when there is a crash, people rush to dividend paying stocks. Now, with the coronavirus, and I could say it, just like Harry Potter could say Voldemort, because he wasn't afraid of getting demonetized, I could say coronavirus, and we could really talk about the issues here. A lot of times when there is a crash, people rush to dividend paying stocks. Why? Because people feel reassured when a big company is having tough times and they're still paying out money. That's pretty good. Gold does tend to go up when there's a crash. However, not always the case. Sometimes gold goes down, not as much as stocks do, but it does go down. This time, this coronavirus, this crash that no one saw coming except for the thousands of experts that warned us for decades, no one saw this coming. Retail, online retail, and big chain stores. So things like Walmart, all-time high. Costco held its value, which means if you had Costco, you could potentially sell it right now and buy some S&P 500 indexes and kind of profit where other people who were just in index funds, they kind of missed that hedge or shield against all this volatility. Now, things that actually skyrocketed are companies like Amazon hit an all-time high. Now, its increase wasn't huge, but it was nice. Then we had Overstock, which went up almost 10 times from the low. That's 1,000%, a very rare event. Wayfair, another online retailer, it went up about 800% from its low about 8 weeks ago. Amazing things are happening in the online retail world. So that's a quick breakdown of what's going on, my mentality investing during this time. Now, how I personally invest. Where was I? So how I personally invest. Monthly check is about $3,000 to $4,000. It's a decent sized check. I think it is a lot of money. And to others, it's not that much. And they make $8,000, they make $10,000 a month. And other people are struggling, you know, making $1,200 a month. But I also have the comfort of this house. It's talking to me. I have my mom. She's okay with me not paying any rent, which means I get extra money to invest. And she sees that I'm investing. She sees I'm prioritizing the future. And she supports that because she didn't have this opportunity. She didn't know it existed. Me, I do. I read all the books. I have them right over there. I don't know if you could see Susie Orman somewhere over there. There's Susie Orman. I got the Intelligent Investor Boggleheads Guide. This is a big passion of mine. Now going into this, I had a rule that I will invest approximately 70% of my income. $2,400 of $3,000 is what I invest every single month, no matter what. Now I usually buy index funds, right? The top 500 companies. How, man, I'm trying to hide all my pimples from you guys. You know what, let's show them. Beautiful. Anyways, people with pimples, just don't hide them or anything. Those are the people that I invest in because they do not care what other people think. Enjoy. I also have a separate investing mentality, and that is when the market drops 30% or more, I will invest extra money. Invested in more index funds than usual. I had an extra $1,000, right? We got that stimulus check. Mine was all invested. And this is what I bought. So that $1,200 that we got, I gave about $100 of it away. I saved $100 for, I needed it for a mechanic. And I left $1,000 and put it into Charles Schwab. They gave me a $100 bonus. The first company I invested into was Weight Watchers. Now, Weight Watchers is a company that is considering the future in an interesting way. Now, again, they're still promoting weight loss, which I think is not that healthy. It's about what you gain from your health journey, not what you lose. So you're gaining new food habits, you're gaining muscles, you're gaining strength. As a byproduct of your work, of your focus, you are losing weight. They have this cool like wellness app, and they have a reward system. So people who are into it will be into it for a long time. There's three types of subscriptions you could have to Weight Watchers, starting at like $2 or something a month, to $5 to $7, having 24-hour access to a wellness coach. That is pretty cool. Oprah Winfrey, one of the head like faces of Weight Watchers. She's really involved with the company as a whole. We know when she came on board, the company skyrocketed from $5 all the way up to $104. Well, during this pandemic, Weight Watchers actually crashed all the way back to $9. And they're climbing back. They're at about $24, $22 right now. Right here, we're looking at it. It says $24. It's pretty good. I invested when it was about $9. So we could see it's up 134%. That is impressive. Other company I invested in is Disney. Now, Disney is something that has been crashing hard, and it got disproportionately affected by the pandemic, by coronavirus. The reason Disney got disproportionately affected is because, well, one, it had a bunch of movies scheduled, right? And people aren't going to theaters, so there goes that. And they have to put those movies on hold, so hopefully they can still create some profit and create some cultural capital that'll be impactful for years, if not decades. Something like Frozen. They got that Mulan movie coming out. Then their parks all shut down. I believe in Shanghai, China, and there's an opening now. We see some movement happening there. But Disney went all the way to $79. I bought in. I bought a couple shares with that $1,000 stimulus. Things have been going pretty well over there. It is up 36%. Next up, we got Starbucks. Now, Starbucks is a company that is worldwide. Now, people talk about diversification, right? They're like, oh, you're not diversifying. You messing up. Well, think about it. Starbucks is a company located across the world. So you're investing in so many different geographies, right? Starbucks, much like McDonald's, which we'll talk about later, isn't just coffee. It's also real estate. So the value of where they're located is increasing. More people are moving in. And of course, there's all sorts of conversations that could be had about gentrification and racism and all of that. But Starbucks is providing jobs to the community. Starbucks is feeding your $5 caffeine craving. I just don't understand it. I have never tasted Starbucks in my life except for the free water that they gave out. And I used to get some cookies sometimes, but I never tasted their coffee, ever. I've never tasted coffee in general. But if I did, I would not be paying $5 for coffee. I know I could get it for cheaper. And the same quality. Just don't get it. I mean, sure, if you're going to meet up with people and you sit down and you talk, yes, I understand a $5 coffee, you're paying for the time. But if you're just going there once a day, just to feed a sugar rush, like, buy some candy. And not at Starbucks. Don't buy candy at Starbucks. They're like $3 cake pop. Don't do that. So Starbucks fell all the way from 100 or close to 100, but down to $55. And now it climbed up to 77. We got Snapchat. Now, this is what I'm talking about. Thinking about the future when you're investing. Snapchat. You need that social connection. Like, people are Facebooking, TikToking harder than ever. Yeah, I'm gonna invest in Snapchat when it falls from like $25 all the way down to $9. I am gonna invest in it heavily, or however much I can with this stimulus check. 128% profit. Next company is Overstock. Now, this one is one of those lottery tickets. It fell all the way to $2. Has went up quite a bit, 451%, not bad. And this is because they're heavily invested in cryptocurrency, and we know that Bitcoin halving is coming up, or it already happened actually, the Bitcoin halving, where the amount of available Bitcoin gets chopped in half. As we know, there's 21 million Bitcoins available eventually, and it gets halved every 4 years of how many free Bitcoin is still out there and people are mining them. This is a whole other conversation. The point is, Overstock is heavily invested in blockchain technology, and Overstock is an online retail, and who profited a bunch during coronavirus? Online retail. So Wayfair, Overstock, Amazon, they're doing pretty great. So Overstock skyrocketed a whole bunch. Now, fortunately, I only put in about, I bought 3 shares, so that was like $7 worth. However, even $7 can make so much impact. I would rather have $7 invested in Overstock than just sitting in my broker account doing nothing. So I do find these penny stocks or stocks that are under $5, and I will invest in them. I will, because that is much better. I will always take that than just having my money sit there in a broker account because I'll wait till next month so I could round up. That $7 already turned into close to $50. I mean, that's great. I could go and, I don't know, get 10 Starbuckses with that. Then we have McDonald's. Now, McDonald's, I don't feel great about, because I don't believe in eating animals for pleasure. A lot of societies have evolved past that need, and we have all the supplements and replacements, and we got B12 going around in pill form, so we can avoid killing animals just to, I don't know, everybody is different, but I think the majority of people, now shout out to the Buddhists, because Buddhists have not been eating meat for generations, hundreds of years, and I think they are a lot healthier than the typical American. By American, I mean the person living in the United States who was over 18. And now we got McDonald's, though. McDonald's is still providing a general good to the public because they have cheap food. I'll call it food. Now, McDonald's does provide to, like, a lot of people who are living on the edge of, you know, living on the streets or already living on the streets. McDonald's is their opening. A lot of families that lost their jobs, you know, $5, they're not going to invest it into something like Overstock and wait 8 weeks for that $5 to become $40. They need to eat now. They're going to go to McDonald's. So with that, McDonald's is still wide open, drive-through is open. I hope they're paying their workers a lot more than they're used to, because their workers are doing a lot more than they're used to. I think they got a little pay increase, but you know, they're generating McDonald's heck of profits right now, where every other company is struggling. McDonald's is not. They've taken a hit, but something like McDonald's is doing fine, relatively speaking. So I did buy it very, very low, and they do pay a dividend, and it's up 41%. McDonald's is still operating, and it is helping families during COVID-19. That is why I invested in it. All in all, the portfolio is up 61%. As we can see, it's at $1,772. Remember, 100 of those dollars came from just the bonus that Charles Schwab gave. That bonus is available down below. That 61% increase does not account for the bonus. So it's just counting the 61% from my gains, the capital gains. Whether or not this portfolio will stay how it is, I don't know. The markets are very turbulent. I would not be surprised if all these gains got halved by next week, or even more dramatic. Heck, I could even be in the reds. But that's what investing is all about. You're not thinking week to week, you're thinking decade to decade. I'm thinking about century to century, but that is generational wealth, and I think that would be a great video for another time. But I did want to share, you know, during these serious times, that there are opportunities for those that are privileged. So don't spend your stimulus check on Starbucks, unless you're buying Starbucks stock. And with that, if you enjoyed that video, like, comment, and subscribe, because there will be more coming at you. Oh, before you go, check out this video over here. It's not a video I like. It's a playlist, a whole playlist for beginners that breaks down all the key concepts of investing. And you know what? I'm going to add another video right